carefully, you could say, boy, him just like his mother. I mean, you could literally say that, just like his mother. And so we thank God for the contribution that Richard has made this morning. Amen. Amen. And so quickly on the announcements, as we run through them, as quickly as we can, we'll go to Tuesday. Tuesday night, we are back in our time of Bible teaching and prayer meeting. And again, this will be both study first in the Word, and then we go straight into our prayer meeting thereafter. And our prayer meeting will be both in church and also on our prayer line. And we'll just run through that as quickly as we possibly can. Again, the prayer line option, option one, just dial the information you see there. The option code. Secondly, if you have an issue getting through, we have an alternate number that you can use, as you see there. Or thirdly, you can also use the app that is also available. But sometimes all these options create confusion and conflict. And so again, the better option really is come to church, for we are here to pray. Amen. And so that is for Tuesday night. Then next week Sunday, we are back in our services, Northeast here at 11:05, Fort Lauderdale 10:30, and Northwest at 11. Coming up quickly coming up is our annual convention. And this starts on the last Sunday, the fourth Sunday of May. And our convention will be in church. It will also be virtual. And our convention will also be live streaming. Starts on the last Sunday, and it ends on Thursday, on the 1st of June. And there will be no meetings on Memorial Day as we observe that holiday. The venue for our convention will again be right here in our Northeast Assembly. Sunday will be broken down into two sessions, basically. The first one starts at 10:05. And following that, we will give you a refreshment to go. And the second session starts at 7:05. And the second session will be fully live streamed, going to be virtual. The first session, 10:05, will be here in Sanctuary. The second session will be virtual, live streaming only. And so please bear that in mind. And then Tuesday back to Thursday, the sessions will be in Sanctuary, and they will begin at 7:35 p.m. each evening. And as we said, we'll be live streaming all our services starting Sunday morning all the way to the end. Also, this one goes directly to our convention choir members, and there'll be no rehearsal this evening, so please bear that in mind as you want to get home to celebrate Mother's Day. Also, we are preparing a digital flyer, which will be ready sometime towards this weekend. And so just look out for that. We will try to text it to you as quickly as it is approved. And so our digital flyer. Also, our convention offering. We have a lot to do this year as far as convention is concerned. And so the ushers have with them our special convention offering envelopes. This is not your regular convention offering, but it's something special to somewhat defray all the additional expenses that we'll be having for this year's convention. And so if you have not yet gotten an envelope, get one today from the ushers before you leave this morning. Scheduled for this week and also into next week, we have two things happening this week. Our work day is on Saturday, the 20th, and next week, Saturday, the 27th, will be our setup day. The deacons have been compiling what needs to be done. And so I'm going to ask you to check with one of them before you leave today as to what you can do as far as the work day is concerned, and in setting up for next week. So this two weekends in a row, we have things that we need to get through. Also, next week, we will be devoting three evenings, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, to sessions of praying towards our convention. Next week, Sunday, we'll give you more details as far as that is concerned. And so again, all this information that we are going through this morning is available from the ushers. So get a copy of the convention information outline from the ushers before you leave today. And again, we ask that you continue to subscribe to our YouTube channel and always give a thumbs up whenever you go there. A couple of the things that we will also continue to highlight. As we announced last week, our dear sister, Sister Mary Green, lost her only other remaining sibling, a brother in Jamaica. And so, Sister Green, again, condolences to you and the entire family on the loss of your brother. Remember, our dear Sister Arbine also lost a relative in Jamaica. We'll continue to pray for them and just anyone who asks us for prayers, brothers and sisters. Let us continue praying for them in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. There's a couple more things to pass on quickly. We always are big into celebrating anniversaries and celebrating birthdays. Do we have any anniversary celebrants this week? This week is your wedding anniversary. Anyone this week? Okay. Birthday celebration, anyone this week? This week is your birthday. Anybody? One young man in the back there. Hey, amen. Run, come here, fat man. Run, come up fast. Run, come quick. Run, come quickly. Run, come quick, 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 quick. Run, come man. Run, 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 run. Amen, amen. All right. Say, today's my birthday. When is your birthday? When's your birthday? When is it? Today?
Friday.
Okay, so what's your name?
Stephen.
Okay, Stephen, happy birthday in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Run back now. Run back. Run, 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 run. Amen. Amen. Deacon Dennis was in Jamaica when his birthday came up. And so Deacon Dennis, happy birthday, sir, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. And amen. At this time, we're going to prepare our hearts to give of our tithes and our offerings. There are a couple more things we will say in a couple of minutes. But you know, I was just thinking, Deacon Charles, don't move yet. I was just thinking. Earlier on, we had a wonderful song that opened up our celebration, where we spoke about the mother said, boy, there is no charge. But hear the argument now. Hear the argument. Think about this. Everyone, no, don't get your offering yet. Think first. You're the argument. If you were to put a price, praise Jesus, on the financial value of your mother, why? And say to God this morning, God, this is the financial value of my mother. Bless it in Jesus' name. Yeah, you hear that? And so the gift this morning, your offerings this morning, is an expression to God. Shall we praise the Lord? Of the value of your mother to God. Amen. You don't have that much. That makes sense. You don't have that much. Well said. Well said. But I would say, as we give an offering this morning, let us give in celebration of God's goodness to us. God's goodness for the mothers that He has blessed us with. And just His goodness and faithfulness all around in Jesus' name. Amen. Bless now, we pray, dear God, the gifts of your children back to your service. We recognize that all things belongs to you. You have just entrusted us as stewards of those things. And so we give you back this morning that which you have already blessed us with. And together, all God's people say, amen, amen. There's a request that came to us also in celebration of Mother's Day. And our dear, our dear Sister Carol wanted us to share this tribute along with her as she remembers her mother in a very special way. And I know that this too will be a testimony for many of us who have lost our mothers. Ushers will now take the morning's offering as we listen this particular Mother's Day tribute in Jesus' name. Amen. Still need to carry on. Although mama is gone, we still need to carry on. Amen. We're getting there. Again, someone sent this to me. Mothers teaches us about the circle of life. I brought you into this world, and I can take you out. Amen, amen. They teach us the circle of life. And I will leave it right there for the time being. Amen. Amen. A daughter presumptuously said to her mother, "Mother, I need my personal space." The mother said to her, "You came out of my personal space." Amen, amen, amen. We're going to invite